cannot copy. Let's talk to Surigao del Norte Governor Francisco Lalo Matugas on the state of typhoon relief efforts in his province. Marazan Nabunta, Governor Matugas, thank you for joining us. Governor Matugas, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Mike. Good morning. Magandang umaga.
Marazan Nabunta, Governor. Let me begin by asking for a situationer, sir. How is the situation in your province? How many casualties as of the latest count? How many missing? How many in evacuation centers?
So far as casualties concerned, I think as of yesterday, mayroon ng 23 fatalities. Then mayroong 8 dahil hindi sa bagyo, kung hindi dahil sa diarrhea dito sa Siargao. Tapos yung mga distribution ng relief goods, so far as distribution is concerned, ongoing tayo. In fact, there are already municipalities na twice, three times na pag-distribute. So hindi lang one time, pero dubli-dubli na. But we're still ongoing. Lahat ng dumadating na mga relief goods, i-distribute kagad namin. Lalo na yung sa mga affected families, yung wala ng bahay, yung walang shelter. So we are also starting to distribute construction materials. Mayroong mga tent, tarpaulin na dumadating, pinapanalan namin, distribute para mayroon namang cover yung mga shelter or yung bahay ng mga affected families. Kasi ngayon dito sa Surigao, rainy season, malakas ang ulan palagi, and we have also another problem kasi yung mga barko, yung mga ro-ro vessel, pag malakas ang alon, hindi makatawid papuntang Siargao from Surigao City.
Sir, let me just clarify, no? Yung 23 that you mentioned, is that for Siargao or for the entire Surigao del Norte? Because
it's,
I seem to recall
Surigao del Norte, yung sa Siargao 18, 18, then yung sa yung sa Mindanao City.
I understand, Governor, you are in Siargao at the moment. Describe to us the situation there.
I just arrived in Siargao. Galing ako sa Surigao City. Kaya kahapon, we had the distribution in different municipalities and barangays doon sa Mindanao.
And how is Siargao at the moment? Is there electricity? Are cell phone signals back?
As of now, wala pang power. Hindi pa na connect, although Secretary Cusi, when he came, promised that by December 31, magkaroon na ng partial energy session in some parts of the island.
How will that work, sir? Because we talked to Governor Yap yesterday, and he was mentioning power barges, which have yet to be authorized by the national authorities. Is that the case also for Siargao and for Surigao del Norte? Will they be sending power barges? Because I can imagine the electric post won't be able to, you know, withstand, or you won't be able to put up the electric post in such a short time.
I don't know yung power barge, no, but right now there are several electric co-ops coming from different provinces, Mindanao. Some are already in Siargao helping us, and also some are in the mainland, in Surigao City and mainland, also helping our local electric cooperative to energize the province, the city, and the island.
And communication signals, are they back or are they still spotty?
Spotty pa. Ngayon, mabuti. As of yesterday, yun of island, signal ng globe. So we are using globe now. Yung smart, ganon rin. Limited to certain areas. Hindi pa nila lahat na or yung mga tower nila.
In terms of funds, Governor, do you have enough funds to continue providing aid to your residents?
Yeah, we have funds because you know it's end of the year. Most of our funds are being used or released for the benefits of the employees. Yun na nga ang problema ng mga LGUs kasi na budget na yan for mga benefits of the employees. But in spite of that, we are trying to make do what we have. Of course, yung mga supports from the private groups, private individuals, they are helping us, donating, especially the national government are also sending their relief goods dito sa island and doon rin sa city and mainland Surigao.
And Governor, I want to talk about the situation in the evacuation centers. How many are in evacuation centers and what's the situation in terms of COVID first? And I understand there is a diarrhea outbreak.
Yeah, we have a diarrhea outbreak. In fact, as of yesterday, we have already treated more than 200. And now in our district hospital, there are 90 or 95 inpatients being treated. Marami pa rin nandoon sa bahay lang nila. But we were able to cope up. Mayroon mga doctors na dumadating helping us from other regions. So parang nakunti na namin yung diarrhea. Because we are treating, lalo na yung potable water, doon nag-based on findings ng doctors galing sa tubig yung nakakus ng diarrhea.
Mm-hmm. How severe is the shortage of potable water, sir, in your province?
Initially, during the first few days of the after audit, talagang acute ang kuha namin. So, lalo na sa Siargao, kasi for 7 days after audit hit us, September 16, walang sea transportation na kasi nasira yung mga Ro-Ro cargo vessels. So, it was only on the 8B na naka-start sila, they resume their operations. And the Philippine Navy and the Philippine Coast Guard has helped us. Pero yung mga vessels nila are small ones, can carry only limited number of tonnage to bring these cargoes to the island.
Mm-hmm. How about the COVID situation, sir, in evacuation centers? Have you been able to test the evacuees and determine if they have COVID symptoms?
You are from the reports I received, nag-negative in Siargao Island, we have zero COVID cases dito ngayon. And yung sa mainland, mayroon, pero hindi na namin masyadong monitor because everybody is been affected by the typhoon. So, but yung COVID, parang nawala ng bagyo.
Lastly, Governor, I'm giving you a few minutes to appeal for help. What is it that you need the most at this time?
At this time, we need construction materials for those families na wala ng bahay. Ito sila. This on our official report and reported also by the different municipalities. Umabot na kami sa 100,000 more or less families. And in Siargao, there are 42,000 families. So ang kailangan ngayon is yung corrugated zinc, plywood, tarpaulins para to cover up temporarily your shelter.
We hope for the best for your residents, Governor Matugas. Salamat Carazo for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Mike.